Good Thursday, everybody. Jewel here with the J7409 Weather Channel. On Thursday, the 8th of December, 2022, another day the Lord has blessed us with. Folks, it's kind of rough around my house. My little cat, she's getting closer to going home. Pray for her. I had a bad episode. I got vertigo. Keep me in your prayers. I would appreciate it. And never lose your faith. No matter what comes your way, and always be thankful for whatever you have, no matter how big or how small it is. We're going to start off. Lots of things are going on. I've checked a bunch of stuff today, and I've been telling you guys about severe weather and that it will probably ramp up in intensity and edgewise some. And that is going to happen. We're going to check that out. We'll have today's high temperatures, and I'll have a general forecast. But before I get into all that, I know a lot of you want to know what's going on with the system out in the Atlantic. Well, I didn't do anything on it yesterday. I did the day before, but I told you, do not worry. It's not going to bother anybody. It's going to fizzle on out. And this is the latest here from the National Hurricane Center. Now, it looks like these showers and thunderstorms, they have increased since last night near a large non-tropical. Remember, it's non-tropical area of low pressure, and it's located over the central subtropical Atlantic. It's about 850 miles east-southeast of Bermuda. However, this system remains embedded within a frontal zone. Now, that's expected to become more pronounced later today as this low begins to move east-northeastward, and it's got a pretty good clip on it, moving about 20 to 25 miles per hour, and it's moving towards closer waters. So that's going to interact with the mid-latitude trough that's coming down. It's going to interact with. Therefore, it could show some subtropical characteristics today, but the chances of it fully transitioning are dropping to subtropical or tropical cyclone. It looks like that those chances are decreasing as I speak. Nevertheless, significant non-tropical development of this low is expected during the next couple of days, but it's just going to cause some rough seas for all you mariners and fishermen out there. It's going to cause some rough seas for you guys, so you guys are the ones that really need to pay attention to it. But the other day it had a 50% chance of forming, and now it only has a 30% chance of forming. Looking at severe weather for today, it's just mostly rain with possibility of some pop-up thunderstorms, but nothing, as I've told you, nothing significant, no tornadoes I don't think is going to come out of this, no heavy shells, no hail, no downdraft winds, but from portions of Texas all the way across Tennessee, you can see up into Kentucky, Arkansas, northern and Mississippi and Alabama, and on the coastline over in the Pacific Northwest for Washington State and Oregon, we got another system coming through. You guys are going to have some rain too. We're going to have some snow, but right now I'm just talking about specifically bad weather events like tornadoes and things of that just carry on. And that looks like it's going to happen when we pop over to Monday. You can see this is a 15% of it starting. Over here in Texas, little bit of western Arkansas and a large portion of Oklahoma. Well, it's only a 15% chance. I think this is probably going to start late in the afternoon or the early evening hours and track right on through Tuesday morning. Now, by Tuesday, it's going to pop up. 30% chance. Where's the greatest chance for these tornadoes, hail, and downdraft winds to occur? A large portion of Louisiana, Arkansas, and that borderline right there in western Mississippi. Everybody else, you still got a 15% chance of something happening where you see the yellow mark, and that's nothing to sneeze at. It could cause tornadoes, okay? We've had them at 2% this year. So we got a 30% chance and a 15% chance. This is all going to start, like I say, late Monday afternoon or evening, carry through Tuesday, and especially, I'm telling you now, go ahead and make sure you have everything ready in case this happens, looking like it's going to, for mid to northern Louisiana and portions of Arkansas. For everybody that likes the cold, well, it's going to be another cold day for many, many across the lower 48 as a system is coming down from Canada. And for all my Canadian friends, this is the high temperatures today in the Fahrenheit mark, not the Celsius mark. Some of you are going to be zero, minus six up in Canada. Look at that. And when we move down to the lower 48, rather chilly, I'd say, 28 over in Washington State. Idaho is going to feel the bite and nip of the cold. And Jersey Dolphins, I'm calling you out. You're in New Jersey. No, you're not going to be cold as these folks, but yes, your temperature is going to start to fall. You should have a high of around 43 to 45 degrees today. Warm spots down in Texas, just around the Gulf Coast states. That's the only place the really warmth is. Now, when you move up a little bit, say for North and South Carolina, it's not bitter cold, nothing we're not used to. It's rather nice. We can save on heat a little bit. We should be in the 50s. That's going to move on across to the Texas Panhandle. When you get right in the Panhandle, though, of Oklahoma and Texas, you're going to start feeling those 40s, and this is going to continue to drop as the days go by. Here we're going to take a look at the GFS map before I turn it on, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. Thank you, Levi, my friend, for letting us use this. Now, a lot of you have said, what about snow for Christmas? Well, you know, that's going to be a little bit hard to predict right now. It's still a ways out, but this is going to go through almost Christmas Eve. This is not the NAM map. This is the regular GFS map, and I'm going to turn it on and pay attention as the days roll by. You got a timestamp up here. There's going to be a lot of ice. I'm not saying snow, but a lot of ice that's going to be coming up in these areas, maybe sleet along with it. Plus, we got snow coming in. So I'm going to turn it on really quick now and give you the forecast for the next few days as you watch this. Now, this meandering front I've been talking about, this interacting with this energetic jet stream from the subtropics, it's going to continue to trigger episodes of active weather across the south central portion of the mainland of the U.S. over the next couple of days, and the interactions already set up a stream of moderate to heavy rain from northern Texas across Oklahoma toward the mid-Mississippi Valley. Now, that's already happening. Now, to the north of this area, this front's just going to keep meandering across, and the focus of the heaviest rains will gradually shift east into the mid-Mississippi and Tennessee valleys as the days progresses before it reaches into Virginia and North Carolina tonight. Now, with this gradual tapering of the rain intensity behind the moisture stream, we got a low pressure wave. Now, it looks like it's going to develop along the front and move across the central plains tonight and into Friday, with a renewed round of moderate rainfall tracking through the mid-Mississippi and Tennessee valleys tonight into tomorrow. Now, north of the track, the low pressure wave looks like the temperatures will be cold enough to support mixed precipitation, including that nasty old freezing rain and drizzle and snow over the central northern plains today. Now, it's going to reach into the upper Midwest by Friday morning. And that's where we could have a few inches of snow expected, and the system looks like then it's going to dissipate Friday as it reaches the Great Lakes. So for all my friends around the Great Lakes, yay! Yay, I'm glad you're not going to get much snow out of this. But on the flip side of the coin, we got another low pressure wave. Now, it's going to form once again over the central high plains Friday night, and then it's going to track quickly to the east. Now, that's going to bring another moderate heavy rainfall event to the same general region from the southern plains eastward to the mid-Mississippi Valley by Saturday morning. Then unsettled weather's in store for all my friends out on the West Coast as a couple of broad and energetic systems from the Pacific, they are forecast to be happening. Now, the first system currently bringing low elevation rainfall and heavy high elevation snows into the Pacific Northwest today. Now, this precipitation will spread farther south into Northern California tonight, and it looks like a little farther inland as the mountain snow across the intermountain region is going to happen there. Now, we got a large low-pressure system that should quickly follow in the wake of the first system. I know, one right after another one. It will quickly follow in the wake of the first system with more heavy, low-level rains and heavy mountain snows. Most of this heavy snow from these two systems are going to be in the higher elevations in the mountain areas, and they're going to be in the Pacific Northwest and Northern California Friday night, continuing right on through the weekend. And that's a check of your weather today. Have yourself a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day, my friends. Thank you for everything you do for me. I love each and every one of you. You might want to share this forecast with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware and safe of just probably what might be coming their way. Peace, love, and kindness to each of you, and thank you so much for watching.